Now the second topic is going to start, the second lecture is going to start on the types of kinetic energy, on the form of kinetic energy. So here we are going to start on the form of kinetic energy, on the form of kinetic energy. So here it is, form of kinetic energy, kinetic energy. The first form is reciprocating. In reciprocating, the form of kinetic energy is defined in, motion is defined in linear path. Motion is defined in linear path, and it is up and down, or it is back and forth. So motion may be like this or here. The second is rotation. In rotation, the motion that is defined on a circular path. And here it is either spinning, or it may be turning like this. So there are two forms of kinetic energy. Now we are going to change the phase, and now we are going to discuss about kinetic energy within intermittent combustion engine. So kinetic energy within intermittent, we have already told you that intermittent combustion engines, for example, Canon intermittent combustion engine. And first is, of course, is according to piston. We are going to take about piston movement, and I already drew a Picasso diagram of piston in the earlier tutorial. Again, I am going to draw it, but now a little bit better than, maybe better than, I'm not sure about it. It is something like that, and there is something okay, and here okay, and here like structure, you know, and it is going to complete. Okay, now I am really feeling, you know what. So piston movement first is intermittent, another one is reciprocating, and the last one is, the piston movement is not very useful to us. And the another motion we are going to discuss about is crankshaft motion. In crankshaft motion, you know the structure of crankshaft like this, and here like this, then this, and you know, I am not expert, you know, but something like this. Here the motion of crankshaft is, first it is connected to piston, because this portion of the piston is connected here, and when the crankshaft move, the piston also move back and forth, and due to rotatory motion of crankshaft, due to linear motion of connecting rod, the crankshaft moved in rotational way. So its main function is it turns linear motion into rotational motion. It turns linear motion into rotational motion. Now we are going to discuss about the thermodynamic principles. Thermodynamic principles. First, in all internal combustion, In all internal combustion, in all internal combustion, it is open cycle, heated engine, opens in all it is open cycle, heated engine. Second, we are going to discuss is gasoline. Can you tell me the other name of gasoline engine? Gasoline engine. It is also known as auto engine, gasoline engine. And in auto engine, first point to remember is it is the spark ignition. And the another thing is remember has is very important is here compressed CMPRESS is compressed is air fuel mixture, air fuel mixture. MIXTURE, air fuel mixture. The third one is diesel engine. You know who invented it? Rudolf Diesel. Diesel engine. Diesel engine, it include two things. First is it is compressed ignition, NI, sorry, IZNITA, compressed ignition. And the another one is compressed air only. Here we compress air fuel mixture, here we compress air only. I'm going to change the page. And now we are going to discuss about parts of IC engine. Parts of IC engine. Parts of IC engine. Parts of IC engine. And in parts of IC engine, first we are going to study the structural component. The main basic bodybuilding components are first structural components is cylinder block. In cylinder block, it is the pa it is the engine frame that contains cylinders in which piston moves. So the structure of the cylinder block is like this. Air contains cylinders. In these cylinders, the pistons, you know, pistons connected to which have connecting rods. The piston moves in these cylinders, and the structure of cylinders is like, you know, this. Like this, you know, my drawing, I'm the Picasso, and it also support it in the above structure. It also support cylinder liners. It also as you support, it also support liners and head. The second, after cylinder block, we are going to study about. The second thing which I recently called is cylinder head, other name of cylinder head is assembly. In cylinder head or assembly, what is its main function? The main function of cylinder head or assembly is it serves to admit confined and release fuel या फिर एयर. इट कवर्स सिलेंडर ब्लॉक. इट कवर्स इट सिचुएटेड इन अपर अपर पोर्शन. इट सिचुएटेड इन अपर पोर्शन हेयर. इट कवर इट एंड दिस स्ट्रक्चर इज नोन एज सिलेंडर हेड. एंड अनदर थिंग इज कवर to cylinder block. It cover to cylinder block. And the third function is it support valve train. What is valve train? We are going to discuss in later tutorials. It supports valve train. And now we have to change the page here. Okay, now the third structure which we are going to discuss is third structural component is it is crank case. The crank case, crankcase. Oh, what is this? I have to crankcase. Crankcase, it is the engine frame section which house the crankshaft, which house the crankshaft. Another thing we are going to discuss is, after crankcase is oil sumps. It is reservoir for collecting and holding lubricating oil. So it act as a reservoir and COWAT is collecting and holding of lubricating oil. Next one is, now we are going to study about moving components. Here a structure component has been, and now we are going to study about moving components. There are three groups according to motion. First group is reciprocating only, and you can tell the name, which is piston and valves. And the another group is both, which is reciprocating as well as rotatory. You can name them. What is this? This is connecting rod. Many are still thinking, what is this? Connecting rod. And the last one is rotatory only. And in rotatory only, it contained crankshaft and camshaft. We have to change new page. So we are on new page, and now we are going to discuss about the moving components. So here the moving components are first is piston is acted on by combustion gases. Here it is piston. So here combustion gases which blow and push down the piston downward direction. It is lightweight. And the another thing is, it is strong and durable. And the another structure is in piston is piston rings. So what is the function of piston rings? Sometimes many students want to know. First is, it transfer heat from piston to cylinder. First main function is, it transfer heat from piston to cylinder. And the second function is, which is more important function, seal cylinder and distribute lubricating oil. Seal cylinder and distribute lubricating oil. Third structure which we are going to discuss is, it also remain in a piston is piston pin. Piston pin, it pivot point connecting rod. It is the pivoted point which connect piston to piston rod. So if this is the piston and this is the connecting road, then this pivot it is which connect piston to connecting rod is called piston pin. Okay, now the fourth structure is connecting rod. Here, you know, my drawing is, you know, Picasso. Connecting rod is this, and here it is bolt like structures which connect it to the lower rod bearing cap. There is a crank pin which is a structure of crankshaft. Here it is a crank pin which is a structure of crankshaft. I show you the crankshaft structure. So connecting rod, what is the function of connecting rod? Connecting rod connect piston to crankshaft. It connect piston to crankshaft. And another most important function is it convert reciprocating motion into rotating motion. No, page change. Now we are going to talk about moving components. So in moving components, first we are going to study is crankshaft. It combines work done. It combines work done by each piston, and it also drives camshaft generator and pumps. So there is two major function of crankshaft. Work done, it combines the work done by each piston, and it's derive camshaft, generator and pump. The next thing is flywheel. So main function of flywheel, it observe and release kinetic energy of piston stroke and smoothen rotation of crankshaft. If there is no flywheel, then the relation of the torque is like this. Because we have flywheel, the rotation is like this. So here there is a huge jerk. We are going to get it. What happened? So main function of the flywheel is it absorb and release kinetic energy. It absorb and release kinetic energy of piston of what? Piston strokes. and smoothens the rotation of crankshaft. So next moving component we are going to discuss is valve, and for this we have to get a new phase. Here, valve. So VLV, valve. Here there are two type of valve. First is intake valve. In intake valve, open to take air to cylinder with fuel in auto cycle, because in auto cycle we take mixture, but in diesel cycle we take only air. So in intake valve, it is open to intake air It is open to intake air into cylinder, cylinder, into cylinder, and there is another valve which is called exhaust valve. Exhaust valve. In exhaust valve, it is open to get out the gases, or we can say it reject the gases. Exhaust valve. The other component we are going to study is camshaft and cams. So camshaft is related to crankshaft. Here crankshaft, this is the last portion of crankshaft. Crankshaft, here is two timing gears, we called it timing gears, and this crankshaft is related to, is attached to piston and with the help of connecting rod, and this the portion of the crankshaft, it attached to the cam shaft, attached to the camshaft with the help of timing gear, and here there is a camshaft, and these camshaft is attached to valve lifters, and these valve lifters, as the name suggests, is attached to rocker arms, and these rocker arms is attached to valve. These rocker arms are attached to valves, and these valve opening and closing of these valve is ensured by rocker arm, which and rocker arm and valve lifter both are connected with the help of push rods. So here these are valves. It is intake valve and it is exhaust valve. These opening of these valve is ensured by rocker arms. And these rocker arms are attached to valve lifters, which is attached to camshaft with the help of push rods. So what is the function of camshaft and cams? It is used to time the addition of intake and exhaust valve. We can understand the meaning later what it means, but for now we can just say it is used to time the addition of intake and exhaust valve. Another is it operates valves via push rods, you know what the push rods are, and rocker arm. And these are the structure, and we are going to take a little bit about the structure. If this is the lower, what is called oil sump, here oil is collected, you know, and in upper there is bearing, you know, which bearing is connected to, you know, connecting rod, and this is called main bearing, and main bearing here is the connecting rod, and this is the piston, and this is the, you know, a small engine. I am not going to draw it with the, you know, my diagram. And there are some definitions which you should know. Definitions. First definition is stroke is the number of times the piston travels the length of the cylinder. And second is cycle. Cycle is composed of four parts. First is intake. In intake, working substance is introduced. Second is compression. In compression, working substance is compressed by upward movement of piston. Working substance is compressed by upward movement of piston. Third one is power ignition. In this case, power ignition, what we do is forcing the piston down. And the last one is exhaust removal of exhaust gases take place. So we have to change the phase. These are the definition of cycle. Now definition of top dead center. You know what is top dead center? Top dead center is when the piston is at its highest point in the cylinder, the volume of the working fluid is minimum, and that point is called top dead center. So it is the cylinder and it is the piston, and when the piston is at highest point, so it is the volume of the working fluid which is minimum. So this point is called TDP or top dead center. The another definition is bottom dead center. In case of bottom dead center, when the piston is at its lowest, this is the cylinder and the piston is here, the piston is at lowest position, at lowest point of the cylinder, the volume of the working fluid is maximum. Volume of the working fluid is minimum in top dead center. Volume of the working fluid is maximum in bottom dead center. The another common term used here is bore. Bore is known as the diameter of the cylinder. So here it is the bore. It is the diameter of cylinder. Another thing which is commonly used is called engine displacement. In engine displacement, the volume of the air that is displaced by all the piston during upward stroke. So this is called engine displacement. The volume of the air is displaced by all the volume of the air that is displaced by the all the pistons during one upward stroke is called engine displacement. Another one is compression ratio. The comparison of the cylinder volume when the piston is at BDC to the volume when the piston is at TDC. So what is compression ratio? Compression ratio is the ratio, or it is the comparison of the volume when the cylinder is at BDC to the cylinder volume when the cylinder is at TDC. So their ratio is called compression ratio. And the next term which we are going to discuss about is engine stroke. A stroke is a single transverse of a cylinder by the piston, that is from BDC to going upward to TDC is known as engine stroke. So the stroke is a single transverse of a cylinder by the piston from TDC to BDC. One revolution of crankshaft is equal to two strokes of piston. So again, the next term we are going to discuss is a little bit mathematical, and it is called engine power. It is the of IC engine. IC engine can deliver power in a range of 0.01 kilowatt to 20 × 10³ kilowatt, depending upon their displacement, how much it displaces. The number of cylinders also vary 1 to 20 with the different configurations. Now we are going to study about four and two strokes engines. In four stroke engine, there is a 2 revolution of crankshaft for complete cycle. Crankshaft revolution is 2 full revolution. Crankshaft rotated 2 full revolution to complete one cycle in four stroke. It required only one revolution of the shaft for completion of cycle. So here two stroke and four stroke has been a little bit discussed. The operation, what happened in operation? Increased pressure of combustion gases act on piston and is converted into rotatory motion. Due to combustion, here a spark is given. Pressure is increased of the combustion gases which act on the piston and is converted into rotatory motion with the help of crankshaft. It can be two-stroke or four-stroke. In the case of two-stroke, there is one power stroke. We are going to discuss about it. One power stroke per one crankshaft revolution. But remember, in case of four-stroke cycle, one power stroke per two crankshaft revolution. And now we are going to discuss a little bit about four stroke IC engine. four stroke IC engine. In case of four stroke IC engine, there is a four stroke or first is induction stroke, and we have already discussed in induction stroke what will happen. It to fill the cylinder with air and fuel. Second is compression stroke. Compression stroke, what happen in compression stroke? It squeezes the piston. The piston squeezes the mixture and it is confined in a very small volume. And in third is power stroke. Power stroke, in power stroke ignition occur and burn and extraction of work is done. So work done mainly happen, extraction of work is mainly happen in power stroke. Last one is exhaust stroke. Exhaust stroke, in exhaust stroke these gases are emptied through a exhaust valve. Now next is we already discussed about we can revise it. In induction stroke, the engine pulls the piston out of the cylinder. Okay, the low pressure inside the cylinder is created due to as atmosphere there is a high pressure, and in the cylinder there is a low pressure. As the gases move from higher pressure to lower pressure, so the intake of air fuel ratio take place. Engine does work on the gases during this stroke. Now we are going to talk about compression stroke. In compression stroke, the engine pushes the piston into the cylinder. The engine pushes the piston into the cylinder. A mixture of is compressed to high temperature and pressure. And engine does work on the gases during these two cycles both. Now we are going to discuss is power cycle. In power cycle, power stroke. In power stroke, the mixture burn to form hot gases. The gas pushes the piston. The gas pushes the piston. The gas pushes the piston out of the cylinder. Gas expands to lower pressure and temperature. Gas do work on engine during this cycle, and all the three cycle engine work in the cylinder, but in the third cycle the gases work on the engine. The last one is exhaust stroke. Engine pushes piston into the cylinder, high pressure inside cylinder, so high pressure to low pressure, the gases went outside, and the engine does work on the gases during these stroke. And we can study about the ignition system also. Ignition system. For example, in cars, the energy is stored in electromagnet. The energy is released in high voltage pulse, and due to the production of high voltage pulse, there is a high potential difference created at the ends of the spark plug, and due to which spark ignition take place. There are two types of ignition. It can be done by battery or it can be done by magneto. The next is it can be done by battery or it can be done by magneto. The next is, we have already discussed about four stroke cycle, and you know heat engines. I am going to summarize the topic because this is the end. We discussed about heat engines, and heat engines are of two types. First is IC engines, and the another one is the EC engines. And IC engines are of two types. First is rotatory, and the another one is reciprocating. and in EC that also the same take place, rotatory and reciprocating. And rotatory is also divided into two parts, if Wankel, which is I told you about, and another one is open gas cycle, or open gas cycle include turbine, and in reciprocating there is a gasoline engine, and the another one is diesel engine. In EC there is rotatory include steam and Stirling. You must have heard the name Stirling cycle. Stirling engine is work on the principle of Stirling cycle. And in reciprocating it is divided into steam turbine, and the another one is closed cycle gas turbine. So closed cycle gas turbine work on EC, open cycle gas turbine work on IC. EC external combustion, IC internal combustion. So for today's lecture has been finished. Thank you for listening, and I have done so many mistakes in this lecture, so I am asking you to give me I am sorry for that. Thank you.